Let's deal with some algebraic expressions that involve multiplying fractions. So let's say that I had a over b times c over d. What is this going to be? I encourage you to pause the video and try to figure it out on your own. Well, when you multiply fractions, you just multiply the numerators and multiply the denominators. So the numerators here, a, c, you're just going to multiply those out. So it's going to be a times c, which we could just write as a, c. That's just a times c, all of that over the denominator, b times d. b times d. Instead of multiplying, what would have happened if we were dividing? So if we had a over b divided by c over d. What would this be? And once again, encourage you to pause the video and figure it out on your own. Well, when you divide by a fraction, it is equivalent to multiplying by its reciprocal. So this is going to be the same thing as a over b times the reciprocal of this. So times d over, let me do that same color just so I don't confuse you, that d was purple, times d over c, and then it reduces to a problem like this. You know what, I shouldn't even use this multiplication symbol now that we're in algebra, because that you might confuse that with an x. Let me write that as times d over c. And what are you left with? Well, in the numerator, you're going to have a times d. So it's ad over b times c. Now let's do one that's maybe a little bit more involved and see if you can pull it off. So let's say that I had, I don't know, let me write it as 1 over a minus 1 over b, all of that over c, and let's also divide that by 1 over d. So this is a more involved expression than what we've seen so far, but I think we have all the tools to tackle it. So I encourage you to pause the video and see if you can simplify this, if you can actually carry out these operations and come up with a one fraction that represents this. All right, so let's work through it step by step. So 1 over a minus 1 over b. Let me work through just that part by itself. So 1 over a minus 1 over b. We know how to tackle that. We can find a common denominator. Let me write it up here. So 1 over a minus 1 over b is going to be equal to, we can multiply 1 over a times b over b, so it's going to be b over ba. Notice I haven't changed its value, I just multiplied it times 1, b over b, minus, well I'm going to multiply the numerator and denominator here by a, minus a over ab, or I could write that as ba, and the whole reason why I did that is to have the same denominator. So this is going to be equal to b minus a over, I could write it as BA or AB. So this is going to be equal to this numerator right over here, B minus A over AB. And then if I'm dividing it by C, that's the same thing as multiplying by the reciprocal of C. So if I'm dividing it by C, that's the same thing as multiplying. That's the same thing as multiplying times 1 over C. And if I am, and I'll just keep going here, if I'm dividing by 1 over D, if I'm dividing, notice this is the same thing as division right over here. If I'm dividing by C, that's the same thing as multiplying by the reciprocal of C. And then finally, I'm dividing by 1 over D, that's the same thing as multiplying by the reciprocal of 1 over D. So the reciprocal of 1 over D is D over 1. And so what does this result with? Well, in the numerator, I have b minus a times 1 times d. So we could write this as d times b minus a times b minus a. And then in the denominator, I have ab C. A, B, and C. And then finally, we can use the distributive property here. We can distribute this D, and we deserve a minor drum roll at this point. We could write this as D times B minus D, whoops, I want to do that same green color so you really see how it got distributed, minus D times A, all of that over A, B, C. And we are done.